Hello, welcome to our CompTIA Network Plus course. In this lesson, we will talk about the common networking ports and protocols such as FTP and SFTP, SSH Telnet, SMTP, SMTPS. You have the DNS, DHCP, HTTP, and HTTPS, NTP, SNMP, LDAP, and LDAPs, SMB, and Syslog. Ports and protocols form the backbone of network communication, providing a structured framework for efficient data transfer. Ports act as unique addresses for specific services, allowing applications to connect and interact seamlessly. Protocols, on the other hand, define standardized rules and formats for data transmission between devices, ensuring compatibility and order in network communications. Start with the first protocol, which is FTP or file transfer. FTP is a standard network protocol used for transferring files between a client and a server on a computer. It operates on a client-server model and facilitating efficient file transfer operations. FTP supports both ASCII and binary file types, enabling the transfer of various file formats, including text documents and executable files. FTP utilizes port 20 for data transfer and port 21 for control commands, providing separate channels for efficient file transfer management. Let's talk about SFTP, or the Secure File Transfer Protocol. SFTP enhances the security of file transfers by leveraging SSH for encryption and authentication. And this protocol offers improved protection compared to standard FTP, ensuring the confidentiality and integrity of data transfer. SFTP encrypts both ends and data during file transfers, ensuring confidentiality and integrity of the transmitted information. SFTP uses port 22, the same as SSH, simplifying firewall configurations and enhancing overall network security. SSH, or Secure Shell, is a cryptographic network protocol that provides a secure channel for data exchange and remote access. It employs a robust encryption algorithm to protect data from unauthorized access, making it a crucial tool for secure remote system administration and file transfers. Now, SSH operates on port 22 by default for secure remote access and facilitating encrypted connections for various network operations. Telnet is a legacy protocol for remote logins, now largely replaced by more secure alternatives like SSH. While it played a significant role in early network communication, Telnet's lack of encryption make it susceptible to eavesdropping and attacks, limiting its use in modern networks. Telnet traditionally uses port 23, though its use is discouraged due to the inherent security risks associated with the unencrypted data transmission. SMTP, or Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, is the standard protocol for email transmission between servers and clients. It operates on a client-server model, facilitating the sending and receiving of email messages across the network. SMTP operates on a client-server model as well for sending and receiving emails, allowing efficient communication between email servers and client applications. SMTP uses port 25 with secure variants using ports 465 or 587 for encrypted email transmission. Let's talk about SMTPS, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol Secure. SMTPS enhances the security of email transmission by adding SSL and TLS encryption to SMTP. It often uses StarTTLS to upgrade standard SMTP connection to secure TLS. ensuring the confidentiality and integrity of email communications. Now, modern SMTPS implementations often use port 587, which start TTTLS for compatibility, ensuring widespread support for secure email transmission. Let's talk about domain name system or DNS. The domain name system is a very important component in the of the internet infrastructure, translating human readable domain names into IP addresses for efficient internet navigation. It operates on a hierarchical naming system, enabling efficient management and resolution of the domain names across the global network. DNS uses UDP port 53 for queries and TCP port 53 for zone transfers, enabling efficient name resolution and data transfer. Now, DHCP, or the Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, automates the process of assigning IP addresses and network configuration parameters to devices on the network. This protocol simplifies network administration and ensures efficient use of IP addresses. Let's talk about the steps that is being followed by DHCP. So the first step is DHCP discovery, where a device broadcasts a DHCP discovery message seeking an IP address from available DHCP servers on the network. The second step is DHCP offer. So here, the DHCP server responds with an offer of an available IP address and configuration parameters to the requesting device. Third step is the DHCP request. Now the client requests the offered IP address from the server, confirming its intention to use the provided configuration. And the last step is DHCP acknowledgement. Here, the server confirms IP address assignment and provides lease information, completing the configuration process. HTTP, or the Hypertext Transfer Protocol, is the foundation of data communication on the World Wide Web, enabling the transfer of web pages between servers and clients. It also operates in a client-server model and uses plain text for communication, ensuring compatibility across various systems. HTTP uses plain text for communication, ensuring compatibility across different systems and facilitating easy debugging and development. Let's go to the more secure one, which is HTTPS, or Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. It enhances the security of web communication by adding encryption and authentication. It uses SSL TLS protocols to establish a secure connection between the client and the servers, protecting sensitive data during transmission. Now, here are the steps for HTTPS for you to be able to download a specific web page. First is the connection initiation. Here, the client initiates a connection on port 443 for HTTPS communication and signaling the start of a secure session. Next is the client and the server engage in a cryptographic handshake to establish a secure connection, negotiating encryption parameters. So this is what we call the SSL TLS handshake. Third, the client verifies the server SSL TLS certificate for authentication, ensuring the legitimacy of the connection. And lastly is the encrypted communication. Here, all data transmitted is encrypted, ensuring confidentiality and integrity of the information exchanged between the client and the server. NTP, or the Network Time Protocol. NTP is also another important component or an important protocol that is used for synchronizing systems clocks across the network, ensuring accurate timekeeping for various applications and services. It employs a hierarchical system of time servers for widespread distribution of accurate information. NTP is critical for log analysis, financial transactions, and security protocols where precise timing is essential for proper functionality and auditing. Let's talk about SNMP, or the Simple Network Management Protocol. So SNMP is a standard protocol for network management and monitoring. It enables the collection of performance and health data from network devices and facilitating the efficient network administration and troubleshooting. So, in terms of data collection, SNMP facilitates the collection of network performance and health data, enabling administrator to monitor and optimize the network operations. All right, now let's talk about LDAP, or the Lightweight Directory Access Protocol. LDAP is a protocol for accessing and maintaining distributed directory information services over an IP network. It uses a hierarchical tree-like structure for efficient organization of information and integrates with various applications for centralized directory and management. LDAP Secure. So LDAP Secure enhances the security of LDAP communications by implementing SSL TLS encryption. It operates on port 636, providing a dedicated channel for secure communication and ensuring the confidentiality and integrity of directory services data. Talk about SMB, or the server message block. Server message block is a network file sharing protocol that enables files and printers sharing across a network. It allows users to access remote files and folders as if they were local, and incorporating authentication and authorization mechanisms for resource access control. So, in terms of port usage, the modern SMB implementations primarily use port 445. For direct TCP/IP communication and streamlining network configuration. Okay. Last topic is about Syslog. Syslog is a standard protocol used for collecting and centralizing log messages from various network devices. It employs a simple protocol for transmitting log messages over the network and facilitating efficient system monitoring and troubleshooting. Syslog utilizes port 514 and TCP port 1468 for long transmission, providing flexibility in network configurations. Okay? So that's the end of the lesson. Here we have a high-level description of the following protocols, like FTP, SFTP. Then we have SSH Telnet, SMTP slash S, DNS, DHCP, HTTP slash S, and you have NTP, SNMP, LDAP, LDAP Secure, SMB, and lastly is about Syslog. Okay? Thank you very much for watching the video.